brought in as the carpenter on the show, and we used to have titles on the show, and mine was Carpentry Creativity, something like that, which was a fun title. Now we're kind of all just designers.
So you're working with your hands?
Yep.
So you're like the guys, you're in there getting dirty.
I am, you know, I have my tool belt when I'm working, the gloves, and I just get dirty, you know, right along next to the guys. But since I didn't want to blend in with the guys, I always wear pink, because I want to stand out. I don't want to blend in with the boys.
Pink page.
That's right.
Okay. And on projects like this, where do you find your inspiration? I mean, when you walk into somewhere, how do you know what you're going to do?
My inspiration always comes from the people that I'm doing the house for. And it's typically children, and I get to theme children's bedrooms, which I think is such a privilege, because it's kind of like you get to live out what you would have wanted as a kid. So every room is different because I just sit with the kid and I ask them what they would like. So if someone wants a princess room, I ask them what they like, what the colors they like, and what they'd like to see in it. And, you know, another girl might want a princess room, but her taste is totally different. So I just try to think all week long, what would this little girl like, or little boy, and just try to make their dreams come true.
What was the one project you remember that you just, wow, the family that is special for you?
My most special favorite family is the Novak family in season 2, and it was in Ohio, and these three little girls just won my heart. They had lost their mom right after their youngest little sister was born, and they're just the sweetest, cutest little girls. So I keep in contact with them today. You know, we go to Disney World times and we get together for holidays, and you know, so many of these families really touch our hearts, but that's one got a special place in mind for sure.
Would that be your most challenging, or was there another one that was most challenging?
The most challenging build we've ever had was actually here in New Orleans about 4 years ago.
Which
yes.
One was that?
We were in St. Bernard's Parish, I think.
St. Bernard Parish, uh-huh.
I don't know. No, wait, that's where we did the hurricane specials. Where were we?
What made it challenging?
When we were here last time, or no, when we were here that first time in New Orleans, what made it challenging is that it rained every single day. You know, we were in a place where you would walk and you'd just be knee deep in water. And here we have these big machines coming in and they'd get stuck. So, and we only have 7 days to build a house. You can't wait for the rain. You can't just wait a couple days for the rain to stop. You have to keep going. And it was a challenge. I mean, we barely made it in time.
And when you think about this particular project that you're working on, where's your inspiration coming from? What are you working on? I know you can't reveal.
Yes.
But where's your inspiration coming from here?
Well, we have so many people. They're heroes to help this week. You know, we've got the Yusei family and this church that we're doing. And, you know, the Yusei family goes out and helps other people. And this church, you know, that's where everyone comes to kind of recharge and then go help other people. So really, we're just giving back to people who can, you know, kind of pay it forward. Once we're done with the house and the church, we know for years they're going to be giving it to others. They're going to be helping others. And so our inspiration is really just to take care of heroes. And then I have the little girl's room. Little girl, she's 2 years old, Audrey. And she did not say a word to me, but she showed me what she liked. She was like dancing and playing and just being a cute little girl. So I'm using her as my inspiration.
So are you going to wow them? You think they're going to be wowed when they?
Oh, yeah. And we have so many like exciting things planned for the family. So each member of the family has something different planned for them. So it's going to be a really big treat when they come home.
The church also too. I know that you're working on doors. I was there and I noticed the things for the cross.
Ed was, yeah. Yeah, you know, Ed and Michael are kind of taking care of the church, and the rest of us designers are at the house.
So
and
you're actually building like furniture, or you're designing what the room should look like? Like how hands-on are you?
We start from scratch. You know, we sit down with the kid and then decide what we're going to do for the room. So we design the room and then we go to work. You know, sometimes we buy things, sometimes we make things, and this time I'm making the bed for the little girl. So I've got my work cut out for me. Yes, I'm building it. Yeah.
You're building a bed from scratch.
Yes. Yeah, I do pretty much every week.
When you leave here, I mean, not everyone leaves their job feeling like I did something. You must feel incredible every time you guys leave a city.
It's amazing. You know, I think we call it extreme amnesia because we go through so much during the week. And at the end of the week, you think, oh, my gosh, I can't go on. I can't go out and do this next week. And then the family comes home and we move the bus and you see the looks on their faces and you see their gratitude. And it just all melts away. You know, it's my favorite part of the week. And it allows us to kind of forget everything we've been through and go on to the next week and help someone else.
And given everything that this area has been through, does this make this area any special in a way when you're working for folks who've been here, given what they went through with Katrina and Rita?
This area especially, I mean, it just touches my heart because you look around and you see that, yes, the city is rebuilding and there's so much hope here. And then you turn a corner and you realize there's still devastation. There's still so much that needs to be done. And I think in our own local areas, the news has kind of gone away. And what we're hoping to do by this show is really raise awareness around the country that there's still a lot of work that needs to be done here and everyone needs to help.
Well, we thank you so much.
No problem.